Okay, Michael, I have two quizzes for you, okay?
Yay.
Here's the first quiz, and here's the way it's set up. I want you to fill in the empty boxes of this table, okay?
Ooh.
Got
there's
it?
There's a lot of empty boxes.
There's a lot of empty boxes.
Okay, but let me make sure I understand what's going on here. So we're looking at three different algorithms that are learning algorithms.
Yep.
There's one neural net.
No.
Okay, one nearest neighbor,
mm-hmm.
K nearest neighbor, and linear regression.
Yep.
And for each one, you want to know running time and space.
Mm-hmm.
And this is on n points, I assume. Yeah, what does it mean for data points to be sorted?
So let's assume that we're living in a world where all of our data points are, you know, in R1. Okay?
Oh. Okay, and well, that could be sorted.
That could be sorted. And that, you know, we're going to be outputting some real number as well. So there are points on a number line. So to make things simple for you, I'm going to say that the points that you're given are already sorted.
Okay. All right. And that makes sense if it's just a scalar. So then a query point is going to come in, and it's going to be some value, and we're going to have to find nearest neighbors or do linear regression, whatever.
Right.
All right. Now, that's for running time. For space, you're talking about the space of what?
How much space you're going to have to do in order to accomplish your task. How much space you're going to have to use in order to accomplish your task.
So this is kind of like the space that's representing the classifier or the regression after training.
Yes. So, and actually that question of after training is important. So you'll notice that I've divided each of these algorithms into two phases. There's the learning phase, how much time it takes to learn, how much space you need to learn, and then there's the query phase. When I give you some new value and you have to output an answer, what's the running time for that, and what are the space requirements for that? Okay, you got it? And I want that for each one of these three algorithms.
Except for one nearest neighbor, which it appears as though you filled in for me to get me started.
Right. So just to get you started and make it easy for you to know what I'm talking about big O times here, right? I'm not going to make you write out big O. Big O is implicit. So if we look at one nearest neighbor and we ask, well, what's the running time of learning? Well, it's constant, right? Because there's no learning.
I see. You just take that sorted set of data points and you just pass it along to the querier.
Right. Now, you could say that, well, I'm going to take the data points and I'm going to copy them into this database, and so it's linear, but let's assume they already come in a database or some data structure that you can use, okay?
Gotcha.
Okay, so now that actually brings us to a nice little question about how much space learning takes here, and well, because you have to store those points and keep them around, the space requirements are big O of N.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Okay, good. So given that as an example, do you think your one example in your database, do you think you can use that to build up labels for all the rest of the phases of the different algorithms?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, cool. Go for it.